We are now just 88 days away from the official release of Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio, as well as creator George Lucas. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, what's really exciting about Episode 9 is that we do know that this film, at the end of the day, is going to be, well, a revelation film with many different twists and turns, as well as surprises in this movie by director J.J. Abrams. That's all set and ready to end the sequel trilogy and the Skywalker saga itself. And on top of all of this, we do know that Episode 9 is going to be inserting many different pieces of nostalgia, as well as new elements of the Star Wars franchise that fans have never seen before on the big screen. Now, on top of all of this, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get very exciting for Episode 9. Now, specifically, shot descriptions consisting of a sequence where it's explained that all 9 Dark Acolytes are said to be surrounding an ancient structure, performing a strange Sith ritual, where it's said to cause a massive thunderstorm in the background, with intense lightning strikes. Now, it's explained to serve as a vision that is seen through Kylo Ren's eyes when touching one of the ancient devices of the Dark Acolytes during Kylo's time in the Dark Spire, where it's said that the Dark Acolytes are said to be hovering over the charred armor of Darth Vader. As this happens, it's explained that a part of Anakin's consciousness is said to be connected to the Darth Vader armor, as well as Darth Vader's. It's explained that they are using the power of the Beyond, which is said to be the origins of the dark side, to create a Sith Wraith of Darth Vader slash Anakin Skywalker. It's said that the sequence is said to reveal to Kylo Ren how the Sith Wraith of Vader slash Anakin was created and brought into the mortal world, which was an original idea by director J.J. Abrams for Star Wars Episode 7. The scene is described to be like something straight out of a horror film that is said to be very dark and gritty, where the figure consists of a cracked Vader helmet under Sith robes that eventually vanishes from the acolytes of the Beyond. So let's go over a couple of parts about this. Now, a lot of fans have always been wondering about the Dark Acolytes. In case you guys did not know about this, the Dark Acolytes really are a big thing in Star Wars Legends that are now being brought back into the Disney Star Wars canon that's going to be used in different ways, starting off with The Rise of Skywalker. So, I want to go over this particular vision that is said to set up the Darth Vader Sith Wraith that is going to appear before both Rey and Kylo Ren at one point in time in this movie. So, JJ, we do know that he wants to make this by far the darkest Star Wars film there is, and by bringing back a part of Darth Vader, the Sith Wraith of Darth Vader, which, by the way, was a big and original idea by JJ for The Force Awakens that he wanted to do, that never made it to the final cut. You can actually even see it in the art book of The Force Awakens. It's a very interesting piece where it's like a half Vader mask and a half Anakin face, and it goes through different phases. The same exact thing applies here, where it said to hold the consciousness of both Anakin and Vader mixed together to create the perfect Sith Wraith by the Dark Acolytes, which are said to be a total of 9 of them. So a total of 9 Dark Acolytes are said to be performing this Sith ritual, if you will, in front of an ancient structure where the Darth Vader charred armor is actually said to be placed over there. Now, what I like so much about Episode 9 is that they really are using elements of the past Star Wars films, the past 8 movies, and using those elements to create something new. In this scenario, we have the burned Darth Vader armor that's being used as a way to be explained in the form of a vision before Kylo Ren's eyes about how the Acolytes of the Beyond were able to bring back Darth Vader into the mortal world in the form of a Sith Wraith, and this scene is actually dubbed as Darth Vader's Resurrection. So what I like so much about Episode 9 as well is that it's also taking a lot of risks when it comes to things that have been implemented in the current canon with, of course, the Star Wars comics throughout 2018. You guys may recall that the spiritual realm really is a big deal to the character of Darth Vader when he actually went in there after, of course, you know, fighting one of the ancient Sith Lords. And that's what I like about Episode 9, is that they're really trying to stay true to not just the prequels and the originals, but they're also borrowing elements from the current canon material of books, novels, comics, video games, you name it, in order to really satisfy pretty much all mediums of the Star Wars franchise, where the fans are all connected to those mediums of this massive franchise that started back in 1977. And without a doubt, Darth Vader really is the true face of the Star Wars franchise, as is Anakin Skywalker. So you can only imagine as to why JJ would even want to do this is because he wanted to do something fresh and new for, of course, creating dark elements in The Rise of Skywalker. Now, the last thing that I just want to go over is that the Dark Acolytes, by the way, are said to reside over in the Beyond. Now, the Beyond is said to be a location that rests in the very center of the Unknown Regions and is said to be the very origins of the dark side of the Force, and that power is said to actually exceed the power of both the light and the dark combined. So that's going to be a very interesting thing to see on the big screen, to see how this power is actually going to be utilized in this movie by JJ. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Again.